Okay, level 4 graphic design. This is assignment GD7, hand-drawn lettering. We're going to start with an A4 sheet of paper, which measures 21 centimetres by 29.7 centimetres. I'd like you to measure 10.5 centimetres from the top and mark both ends. Draw the first tram line. That's the centre line. Measure 5 centimetres down from the top, mark both ends, and draw your second tram line, that's the top tram line. Measure 16 centimetres from the top, mark it at both sides, and draw your third tram line, the bottom tram line. Now the A4 page is almost 30 centimetres wide, so measure 15 centimetres from the left at the top edge and the bottom edge, and draw your vertical centre line. Here it comes. Now measure 2.5 centimetres to the right of that centre line and drop another vertical line. It should reach 1 centimetre above the top tram line and go right down to the bottom tram line. On the bottom tram line, make a mark 1 centimetre left of the centre line and another one 6 centimetres right of the centre line. Join these marks with your ruler to the top of the vertical line you've just drawn. That's the beginning of a letter A. Then on the top tram line, measure 7 centimetres to the left of the centre line and drop a short line down 1.3 centimetres. Drop another short line at the centre line, 1.3 centimetres, and 3.5 centimetres left of the centre line, drop a vertical line all the way down between the top and bottom tram lines. That's the beginning of your letter T. Now every part of your letters is going to be 1.3 centimetres thick, so remember that. Now if you measure 1.3 centimetres down from the top tram line and at both sides and make a new line right across, that'll be a useful thickness for your letters. Then thicken the vertical line of the letter T by coming out 6.5 millimetres either side of the line, the stroke line of the T. This will make the upright stroke 1.3 centimetres. And at the left-hand side, mark a new line 1.3 centimetres above the bottom tram line, coming in 6 centimetres from the edge towards the centre. Now we're going to thicken the legs of the letter A. Figure out how to make a new line inside the angled lines. They should, of course, make legs 1.3 centimetres thick. Make a crossbar for the A, 1.3 centimetres thick. It should be below the centre line. You can decide just where. The part of the A that appears above the top tram line can be rubbed out. Just for clarity, I'm filling in some of the letter shapes. You can do this at the end. Next, we're going to start the R. Drop a vertical line 7 centimetres to the right of the centre line. Make another vertical 1.3 centimetres to the right of it. This is the upright stroke of your letter R. The width of the letter R is going to be 6 centimetres, so measure 6 centimetres to the right of the first vertical you made and draw a line 1.3 centimetres below the horizontal centre line. There it is. Now draw a vertical from the end of this new line up to the top tram line and another vertical 1.3 centimetres to the left of it. You've something like a squared off letter P. Mark the halfway point on the inside of the box you've drawn on the right hand side. This is a guide for the curves you're going to draw. Watch the video carefully. My animation gets a little bit odd here. So here are the curves. You have to draw these freehand, draw them lightly, and keep correcting them until they look good. If you're very smart, you could use a compass, but it's good to do it freehand. Now, when those curves are in place, we're going to look at how the leg of the R is drawn. You can follow that from the video. There we go. 1.3 centimeters between those lines. And at the top, they don't go straight into the body of the R. You'll see now a couple of curves in there, make it look nicer. There's the letter R. And we're shortly going to move over and do the letter S. The S is entirely made of curves, but it's important to have good guidelines first of all. Measure 1 centimetre left of the top bar of the T. And drop a vertical there. Wait till it comes up on the video. Another one, 1.3 centimetres to the left of that. And another one, 6 centimeters to the left of that. Another one, 1.3 centimeters to the right of that. Okay, so you've got, looks a bit like a letter H, a large box. Now you have to put a crossbar in the middle. You'll see I put mine too high, first of all. It should be slightly above the middle. I'm going to adjust it now. And 1.3 centimeters below that. That's it. So that's your center bar. So you've got essentially a squared off letter 8, number 8. And I want you to watch the video and see how the curves are made to create your letter S. It's easy to go wrong with these curves. You might try it a couple of times, make like marks and correct them. So for the top of the S, I've drawn more than I had to show that it's really an O. In the bottom, I haven't drawn in the complete O, but it's really like a figure 8 with parts left out. Here we go, building the S, and horizontal line to cut off the end of the stroke, both at the bottom and the top. Here we go, that's the letter S, and we can fill that in, and I'm just going to fade out the construction lines and block out the letters so you can see it clearly. Now you might want to watch this video 2 or 3 times. You can pause it, go back, go forwards. Remember, these dimensions are for an A4 sheet of paper. If you want to use an A3 sheet, you can either figure out the dimensions yourself or email me and I will give you the dimensions for it. There you go, best of luck. You can colour in your letters when you're finished.